Hi, welcome to the part 5th of transition metal catalyzed homogeneous asymmetric hydrogenation. Now, asymmetric hydrogenation of alpha dehydroamino acid derivatives has been used to prepare a number of important intermediates. So, the compounds alpha dehydroamino acids undergo asymmetric hydrogenation to give an alpha amino acid, and that alpha amino acid is act as an intermediate and it undergo further reactions to give an important product. See, the researcher Gallagher and others employed asymmetric hydrogenation in the preparation of an alpha amino acid intermediate in the total synthesis of minus ephenorphine. So, see the starting compound, which is alpha dehydroamino acid. It undergo hydrogenation in presence of rhodium ethyl diphos catalyst. So, this carbon-carbon double bond undergo hydrogenation. Hydrogen gets added across this carbon-carbon double bond, and chiral center is formed at this carbon, which is attached to nitrogen. And the product or this intermediate obtained in greater than 99% enantiomeric excess. And this undergo further reactions to give minus ephenorphine. So, this first reaction is important for us because there is a formation of chiral center by using this rhodium ethyl diphos complex, which act as a catalyst by using asymmetric hydrogenation reaction. Second reaction is, researcher Fukuyama and others reported the total synthesis of plus menzamine A. It is a naturally occurring beta carbolin alkaloid. See, again, this is starting compound. There is a presence of carbon-carbon double bond. The catalyst used is rhodium ethyl diphos. So, rhodium is a transition metal and this ethyl diphos is a chiral ligand. So, they together makes chiral catalyst. Hydrogen is there. Pressure is 1000 psi. Methanol is solvent and reaction performed at room temperature. So, hydrogen gets added across this carbon-carbon double bond, and there is a formation of chiral center at the carbon which is attached to this nitrogen. Again, enantiomeric excess is greater than 99%. Now, this intermediate undergo further reactions to give that menzamine A. Next reaction is synthesis of S minus acromalobic acid. Now, again, in this starting compound, there is a presence of carbon-carbon double bond. The catalyst is rhodium RR dipamp. Methanol is solvent and it undergo hydrogenation. Asymmetric hydrogenation take place at this carbon-carbon double bond. That is, hydrogen get added across this carbon-carbon double bond, and the chiral center is formed at this carbon which is attached to nitrogen. Enantiomeric excess is again greater than 98%. It further undergo reaction to give S minus acromalobic acid. Then synthesis of R metalaxyl, which is a highly active fungicide. In this compound, this carbon-carbon double bond undergo hydrogenation in presence of this rhodium RR methyl diphos catalyst. Rhodium is transition metal and this methyl diphos is a chiral ligand. Okay, they make a chiral catalyst. So, hydrogenation gives us formation of chiral center at this carbon which is attached to nitrogen, and this is a R metalaxyl formed in 98% enantiomeric excess. So all these compounds are important products, and synthesis, rather we say at the multi-step synthesis of these important products involve one of the step which we call as a key step, as it is a asymmetric hydrogenation reaction. Now the hydrogenation of beta-beta disubstituted alpha dihydroamino acids by homogeneous metal ligand complex has been a challenging task. It is mainly due to the steric hindrance when the substrate coordinates to the metal catalyst. Now see what happens actually. Our substrate, which is now beta beta disubstituted alpha dihydroamino acid, it coordinate to the metal catalyst. Now there is a presence of two substituents on that beta carbon, so that two substituents increases the steric crowding. Steric hindrance is there. Therefore, that hydrogenation is a challenging task. So it requires high catalyst loading, and also it causes slow reaction rate in such a type of reactions. Now, when the substrate bears two different beta substituents, two stereogenic centers are generated simultaneously. Now see these examples. In first example, this beta carbon has two different substituents. Here OTDS is there, methyl is there. Catalyst is rhodium RRSS propyl trap. It undergo hydrogenation. Hydrogen get added across this carbon-carbon double bond. Now due to presence of these two different substituents, two stereogenic centers or chiral centers are generated simultaneously. So both these carbons are chiral carbons. This happens whenever there is a presence of two different beta substituents. See another example. In this example, add beta carbon atom, two different substituents are there. Catalyst is same, rhodium RRSS propyl trap catalyst. Hydrogenation take place and two chiral centers are formed. Third example, again in this example, add the beta carbon atom, two different substituents are there. So in presence of this chiral catalyst rhodium RR methyl dufos, it undergo hydrogenation to give two different chiral centers or stereogenic centers, and 96% enantiomeric excess is there. Again in this example, see this compound, this carbon-carbon double bond undergo hydrogenation. Rhodium RR methyl BPE is act as a catalyst here, and that product is obtained in 94% enantiomeric excess. So in this part we have seen the synthesis of some important compounds. That synthesis involves asymmetric hydrogenation reaction as the key step. Thank you.